Lucy, I told you, you cannot go with me.
Yeah, I know you told me that, but you didn't mean it.
Yes, I did mean it.
But, Ricky, you're having lunch with Richard Widmark at Romanoff's.
Correct.
Well, why can't I go with you? Give me one good reason.
I don't want you there.
Ricky, look. If you say I can go with you, I promise I won't say a word. All I want to do is just sit and drool at him. Honey, you won't even know I'm there. I'll be as quiet as a mouse. I won't eat very much, just a little piece of cheese. I'll even pick up the check for the whole lunch. How about that?
No, thanks, sport.
Please, this is the opportunity of a lifetime. Please say I can go with you.
You may not go with me.
Ricky Ricardo, can you look me in the eye and tell me I cannot have lunch with Richard Widmark, my idol, my dream man?
You cannot have lunch with Richard Widmark, your idol, your dream man.
Would you like to try the other eye?
Now look, Lucy, let me try to get this into that little thick skull of yours. Now, I am not positively, absolutely taking you along with me, definitely.
Well, it finally happened.
What has?
I knew the day would come when you'd go too far. I'm gonna punch you in the nose, Buster.
What?
Come on, I'm gonna paste you one, kiddo. Come on. Come on. Come on now. Ricky? Ricky, come on now.
Hey, what's going on?
Nothing. Calm down, will you, Lucy? Calm down.
What'd he do?
He's having lunch with Richard Widmark at Romanoff's, and he won't take me along.
Let me at the dirty rat.
Hey, hey, now, never mind, Rocky.
Never mind.
Honestly, I am never going to tell you when I'm having lunch with anyone again.
You didn't tell me this time, remember?
Well, I'm never going to have a telephone with an extension again.
You're just being mean. You know how much I want to meet him.
Oh, Ricky, why don't you take her along? What's the harm?
I never thought I'd agree with these two, Rick, but why don't you take her along?
Well, well, well. It's very obvious that all of you are going to buyer me, so...
Buyer me?
You know what I mean. I think there is something that all of you should know.
What?
Well, in this short 3 months that we've been out here, Lucy has become a Hollywood legend.
Me, a Hollywood legend?
Yes, that's right. When I'm out in the street, people point me out and say, there he goes. That's the fellow that's married to that red-headed screwball.
Oh, they do not.
And then the first thing they want to know when they meet me, is it true that she threw a pie at Bill Holden in the Brown Derby?
I told you I did not throw that pie. The waiter bumped into me.
Well, yeah. And then they want to know if she really sneaked into Cornel Wilde's room dressed as a bellhop.
Well,
And the commotion that orange that she had Robert Taylor autographed for her
now
at the farmer's market.
Now, listen, there's a good logical reason for everything that's happened to me.
Well, I'm sure that there is, honey, but I haven't got time to listen to them now. So, I'll see you later, character.
Hey, hey. Yeah, I'll see you.
I don't like that tone. You are thinking again.
There's no law against my going to Romanoff's, too. And perhaps dropping by your table and delivering a cheery little hello
Lucy.
To someone that I
Lucy.
Think is real
Lucy.
Dreamy.
Lucy! I want you to listen to me, and I want you to listen very carefully. If I as much as see your face in Romanoff, I am going to wrap you up in brown paper and mail you back to New York. And that's an ultimatum.
An ultimatum?
Well, I'm not surprised.
I am. I didn't think he knew how to pronounce it.